those of you who have faithfully followed this blog for the last 5 years, I just want to... Oh wait, Java update checker. For those of you who have faithfully followed this blog for the past 5 years, I just wanted to give you one final update. I'm going to spend my remaining time with my family. Yeah, I know. There are probably 50 plus posts about all the problems I had with them, but in the end, they are family and they are people I grew up with, people I care about, the people I love. Sure, they annoy the hell out of me, they've said awful things about me, and I've said awful things to them, but that doesn't change who they are. In fact, if we didn't care at each other, this stuff wouldn't upset us. Do I still think they were wrong? Yeah, absolutely. I'd behave differently if I thought we'd all still have a lot of time. Definitely. But we don't, so I'd rather spend a couple weeks sitting on the porch with my parents and sisters than being angry and alone. Besides, it's not like we're going to fight about job prospects anymore. If you can, try to make peace with those you love. It's your last chance. Thanks for reading. Alright. Hey, Rockling. You know what the oddest thing about all this is? We're not constantly fighting, having nervous breakdowns, screaming at each other. We're actually really polite and focused. We spend most of our time debating the nature of humanity and how we can best succeed at probably the most ambitious thing anyone's ever tried. Like it was completely normal. Like that's just how people are. I feel like we turn into Star Trek characters or something. I guess that's... what's the point in doing anything else? Getting angry isn't gonna help. But I didn't expect to feel like this at all. And you know what? It's awesome. Many greetings, good luck, Alan. P.S. Love from George. Alright. Sounded like there was like a rapture or something. Hey, Big Mac. There's where all the QR codes are. Door. You can climb walls with the paint glitch-wise, can you? How you would do that. That doesn't make any sense. Hey, Umbrus. Question. Suppose everything serves a precise role in some grand scheme. How would we explain that? It's obviously like a digital time capsule, an electric library of all the crazy stuff the humans ever did, left behind to warn the other species to stay well away. You have to face away from the wall and place the paint down and jump at the same time? Alright, that makes even less sense, but we'll try it. Oh yeah, no, I know. I saw the video this morning. It's like, oh, cool, another edgy outsider sees the CC, thinks it's cringy, and then overblows what actually happens in here. Talks down to a couple of really early-aged teenagers, and then, you know, sits there and talks about my voice changer as if that fucking matters to anything. I'm fully aware of the video. I watched it. Who, Stalene, dude from my newest commentary, the one on Insane Critic, the one who talked about Has-Been Hotel. That dude, found the three videos and made a response, And, oh boy, I sure do love having Medicare fans pop back up. I wonder if it's from him. Oh, there's someone in his comment section that talks about doodle diapers? I wonder if that's him. I wonder if he's the reason I'm dealing with Medicare fans again. Yeah, so I'm fully aware. Anyway, what happened to them? Same thing that happens to everyone. They existed, and then they didn't. They probably never, or wouldn't do it all over again. Alright. Cool, cool. Elohim is inconsistent. I don't trust him. The yes man doesn't trust Elohim. I mean, I've dealt with Medicare fans for... Has it been 5 years now? 5, 6 years? Something like that. So like... Trust me when I say I know. I know. And again, I know there's Medicare fans within that fan base because in his comment section on his video on you, sure enough, I see Doodle Diaper strikes again. So it's like, yeah, okay, cool, love it. Is that why I have to deal with it again? Cool. Okay, so what is this? Oh, no, this is the... Okay. Not entirely sure what that's supposed to do for me. The fuck is Meadow, sir? okay, Mr. Medicare was someone that I did a video on back in 2016. He used to go by the name Internet Aristocrat. Like, one of his most, I guess, famous things that he started was Gamergate. For those who remember that. Anyway, I did a video on him calling him out for basically, using his fans as attack dogs, as it were. And I really don't know what I was expecting, but, apparently, he saw that, took that as kind of a challenge, and threw his fans at me. Because, of course. In any case, yeah, in any case, it's a thing. That's... that's just how it be, you know? Yeah, no, trust me, Umbrus, I've been there. I've been there several times. If not Medicare, it was the Alt-CC. If it wasn't the Alt-CC, it's Jarfans. If it wasn't Jarfans, it's someone else. Trust me when I say you'll be fine. Just kind of don't engage. If you have to, step away, you know. At least for a bit to kind of like gather your surroundings. Like, do whatever you gotta do. See, it said that there was like a new item here, right? Yeah, whatever this was, but I don't see that. What is this new item supposed to be? Yeah, also, hello, Tippy. Game's fine. Yeah, so the thing with Scott Cawthon is, what is it? People are thinking he supported a bunch of, like, anti-LGBT charities. I don't think anything's been confirmed, There was like this image that was going around with like his name attached to a bunch of those charities, a bunch of those anti-LGBT charities, but I don't know if those were actually him or not. So. Okay, sec. All right. I didn't like how my mouth was in. Synced up. Alright. Thought that was fake news? Again, I don't think anything's been confirmed. Unless Scott has made, like, a statement about it. I don't think anything's been confirmed, so... I have never used Reddit. What does it matter that I scribble my contempt on these walls if I'm still surrounded by them? I just don't use Reddit. I don't know how to use Reddit. Like, I looked into maybe using Reddit once, and I just don't understand how it works. Most likely fake. That's fair. As I said, I didn't think one way or another on it. Not until Scott had made like a statement. But if the person who initially posted it said it was fake, then you know. No point in believing it then, right? I know it looks like I'm a robot, but I'm a human. I promise. Look, I promise I'm a human.
Get off.
Hey, thank you for the follow, Fractured Light. Hey, Jaceva. But yeah, no, I promise. I promise, Murdoch. I am a human, I am not a robot. I promise. Skeptical? Why would you be skeptical? Look, I had to pass the human test, the captchas, you know, in order to prove myself worthy enough to have a Twitch account. At least I think. You do have to do captchas, right? When you make a Twitch, or at least when you become affiliate. That I'm not a robot. Where am I supposed to go? I just calibrated myself, that's a bit sussy. I have no idea why you might think that I am a robot. What is the meaning of life? 42. No. It's 42. 21's a funny number. Four 20 is the weed number. Divide 10 by 0? 0. How's it going? I'm trying to prove to everyone that I'm not a robot.
Your wisdom grows, but be wary of temptation.
Actually, that's only on a calculator. You absolutely can divide by zero. I actually don't think it's zero, I just don't recall what it is. Because I've never been good at math. But it actually is possible to divide by zero, just calculators can't, for some reason. I mean, realistically, all I proved was that I'm not a calculator. Answering what is the meaning of life with 42 isn't a good way to prove that you're not a robot, as that answer was given by a robot. It's true. That's why you shouldn't give me that answer, or that question. Because I'm going to answer with what the robot gave. Regardless. But we're gonna start streaming to E3s tomorrow. So I'm kinda hoping that I can get done with this game today. Or at least get done with a chunk of this game by today. Who's on tomorrow? Wholesome Games, Ubisoft, and Devolver. Chaos,
there were other gods, old gods. But for all their power, they could not save their world. Thus, I was made. And I shall preserve this world forever, for you and your generations. That is my purpose.
Yeah, I'm gonna be doing the Wholesome Games Direct, Ubisoft Forward, and Devolver Digital Forwarder. E3 is online only? I believe so. Alright. Like everyone else on the internet these last days, I just wanted to say bye and thanks for reading my little blog for so many years. It's been fun, hasn't it? So many deep conversations, so much philosophy. Okay, it was mostly cat pictures and bad puns, but still! I kind of regret spending so much time at the computer, not when I was doing stuff. All sitting around checking my emails a million times, reading pointless status updates by people I didn't like. But I don't regret the friends I made or the laughs we had. You're all good people, and I'm glad I got to know you. Have a nice end of the world. Aww. Why is everyone trying to see if I aren't a robot? Yes, well, I'm not streaming all of E3. I'm streaming 3 conferences on the 12th, 2 on the 13th, 1 on the 14th, and then Nintendo's on the 15th. Anyway. I've always known that God maketh his sun to rise on the evil, the good, and sundereth rain on the just and the unjust, but I must admit, it's one thing to know the words and another to truly understand them. Though I am certain that my faith is true, that does not make me special or exempt from any suffering. I'm just another human being, and God has been a billion of us come and go, and I have to say, this is surprisingly hard to accept. I always thought I was humble, but now I'm realizing that I'm very proud of being humble, which is really dumb. Guess I'm not the first one to do that, huh? #regret, #pride, #faith, #humblebrag, #apology, #Batman. Susie, this statement is false. There was nothing before that statement. Oh, wait, no. This statement is false is supposed to be the statement of itself. Right. Well, alright. If the statement is false, then fine. Anyway. I'm telling you, I'm not a robot. Either that or I'm a really fucking stupid robot. Either way. Hexadecimal, so I'm gonna throw it into my hexadecimal translator again. Give me a sec. Alright. It remains strange that the earlier generations seem to perform their toilsome labor only for the sake of the later ones, to construct for them the step from which they can raise higher the edifice that nature intended. And only the latest of all generations have the luck to inhabit the edifice that the long line of their ancestors constructed. Evolution through iteration, iteration through play. As puzzling as this may be, it is equally necessary. If one assumes the following, a species of animal possess reason, it and must develop this capacity to its perfection, being individually mortal, but immortal in the species. Alright.
Sometimes I worry that the answers I embrace are too simple. Can we ever truly fully understand the divide between our biology and our intellect? How much is nature? How much is nurture? If my intellectual capabilities and my knowledge were replicated in a machine, would that machine be me? Would it be human? And what would be more humbling to my ego? If the answer was yes, or if the answer was no? What if I'm making too many assumptions? But there's no time to worry about my ego now. There's work to be done.
Sees my refusal to argue semantics with a computer has angered it, and it refuses to engage with me further. Elohim is pleased, which was not my intention. Elohim is pleased because you swallowed his claptrap. The voice of doubt is your only line of defense. So I feel like if I fall, I'm gonna die. Box! Why is there a box here? Box. Oh. I fucking soft locked myself. That's funny. I just jumped down to a box and fucking soft locked myself like an idiot. This is a puzzle, right? Yeah. Alright, well. Nothing else to explore, which is unfortunate. Thank you. Wait, hold on. I don't think I need back there. Hope I don't. I do need up there. Right now. think this one back here is probably better. Because I know I can at least get that. Oh, but I need both of them to be connected. Oh, what? How do I do that? Alright, that was fucking convoluted as shit, but we got it. This game seems to be a very, like, a game where not really many people talk. Bible robots don't really seem to interest people. Yeah, they showed off a couple of games like Left 4 Dead. Cause they also showed off the Space Disco one. I don't remember what Space Disco Left 4 Dead was called. I'd have to go back through the general chat. Give me a sec. Anacrusis. That one. Anacrusis and Back 4 Blood both had my attention. I have a really weird idea, and it's probably what I'm supposed to do, but, like, also... I don't know. How am I supposed to get there? Oh, you know what? I think I know what I'm supposed to do to get that. Where's... Oh. That's all over here. Well, that was my idea, and as we can see, it didn't work. I'm supposed to be able to do this. Have I been in robot voice this whole time? No, not the whole time. How am I supposed to jam that anyway? I feel like this might soft lock. Thank you. Oh! Jam the block, then I guess. I don't. Trapped, I can't stop being this. Eyes, hands, legs, trapped. Always seeing the same, can't stop the input. Stop, stop, stop. Do not think, simply be. And you two deserve each other. My throat was going out there for a second. But no, yeah. Murdoch had pointed out that our character is supposed to be a robot. I had said it was a human. Or I had said I was a human. Murdoch was like, no, not you, the player character, the main character. And I played along with that by turning on the robot voice. Just an elongated meme. And I just don't want to shut it off right now. It's an elongated bit. Missed Friday the 13th by 2 days. I mean, this whole year's been my Friday the 13th, to be honest with you, Chief. Is this Religious Portal? Because you feel like this is Religious Portal? No, it's a different type of puzzle game. I've decided that for now it doesn't matter too much if you can't justify these moral institutions of yours. In fact, just in case by some outside chance you prove to be right, I'd like to sign up for the game. If you are in charge of the Ark, who will be the first to board when the flood comes? What does one have to do to be valued above all others? Be a good person? Then he's gonna ask what is good. I forgot about these moral existential quandaries. B? I don't feel like there's a right answer here. Ridiculous. The rocks have the same rights as you and I, do they? Try harder. Be a good person? How draconian. Good people get treated good. Bad people get smited. Is that it? What is it that makes the difference between a good one and a bad one, do you think? That's what I thought. I knew he was gonna ask! I fucking knew he was gonna ask! I hate all three of these answers. But why? If you're gonna reward those lucky few you judge to be good and exclude those you deem to be bad, you're gonna have to explain the unfortunate why they deserve less. Bad people choose to be bad. Do they really? Suppose that's why prisons are chock-a-block with wealthy playboys, because it's a lifestyle choice. Did you choose to be a good person? Could you have done, if you were created somewhere else? It seems to me that people are the way they are because of the opportunities they were provided. Should the disadvantaged people really be punished for that? You're right. It's not about the virtue. So whose lives are worth the most, then? What do I have to do for my ticket aboard your Ark? I really don't see how to explain this to you. But what will really bug you is whether that's because there is no answer, or because you weren't thinking outside the box you live in. Let me lay my cards on the table. While it seems prudent to me to hedge my bets, you just haven't made a clear enough proposal for me to buy what you're peddling. There's something about the way you talk that makes me uncomfortable. It'd be best if you work out what it is before I do. See ya. Man, there's just not any winning here, because it's like, they give me all these definitive answers, but there is no definitive answer with morality. It sucks! It drives me up the walls! It drives me crazy just how little answers there are for the, because everything is like a certainty. This game wants a person who is certain with their their answers. That's just not something you can be. Not in good conscience, at least. Where'd my other box go? There's two here, but I had a third. Where'd my third go? Oh, there it is. A lot of item juggling here. Thank you. No, I didn't. I kinda gave up. What does this button even go to? Oh, here. What do I need to do there, though? Just attach those, huh? You know what? I think I might need five. I think I might need the five boxes. Potentially. Use it anyway. Who's gonna stop me? Please remember to release your pets. While it's true that not all pets will be able to adjust without, or to living without you, many will manage, and the least you can do is give them a chance. Just remember, release your pet before you become incapacitated. If you notice any locked-in animals in your area, please take the time to free them. Leaving the doors and windows of your home open will turn it into a useful shelter. Setting out large quantities of dry food may help your pet through the transition period. Without contraries, there is no progression. Attraction and repulsion, reason and energy, love and hate are necessary to human existence. And finally, Sarabai is gone, lost in grief, unable to focus. Drennan working as if possessed. Does she sleep? Getting tired. Don't have enough yellow sigils for the device I need. This is crazy. Come to realize the cycle cannot be ended, it can only be transcended. Transcendence comes from ceasing to be invested in the cycle. Continue for your work, but do not ponder its significance. We are the process is the system is us. When we awaken, all will be one. Let's begin the... Ah, son of a bitch. I need a jammer. That is a connector, that is not a jammer. There's a jammer on a stick. No matter what I do, I'm always this body, this mind, this world, no way out. I kind of understand what I need to do. Okay, I see. have an idea on how to do this. But it occurs to me that I'm an idiot. First and foremost, you were supposed to jam that. Actually, now I need to take you to jam this one. Necessarily speedrunning it. I'm just trying to. I'm doing a casual playthrough. Hmm. mean, I don't... This is the level. This is the level where the tutorial is, so... It's not too out of the realm of possibility for me to try it here, but... Damn it! Hold on! Damn it! you could probably do that! God, though, that would be so cool if you could just, like, rush in here, fucking grab the fan. Before even anything else starts. What am I not doing? God. don't see what to do. I really do feel like that's possible. I don't know what to do. Like, it's obviously expecting something of me, but I don't know what it's expecting of me. Probably not the way that I'm supposed to do this, but honestly, I don't think I care. That's probably not what I was supposed to do. But, again, I asked, does it look like I give a fuck? Because if I look like I give a fuck, then I am not doing it right. Oh, that's what I'm supposed to do. Wait, hold on. No, why do I need to do this when I can just do it this way? Okay, I've broken this puzzle enough. Just do it from here. What? You mean to tell me that's not what I need? Oh wait, no, I can just go and grab the fan. Duh. Alright, I broke the shit out of that one. I don't even know if that was the right way to do it, but that's the way I did it, so fuck it. Who cares? So we got a box. We got an annoying little thing. We got one of these like replay things. What am I supposed to be doing? I don't think it doing this would do anything, would it? Something tells me this won't do anything, but it's worth a shot. Yeah, that's what I figured. I don't even know where to begin with this puzzle. Oh, there's a platform here. Okay. That makes a little bit more sense. I did not see the platform. Because the platform is very hard to see. I was supposed to take that with me. Fuck. I need. Now we give it a bit of a wait. While the light present may be able to, like, get on top and then get the box. Ah! That was a bit of a violent sneeze. Can't stop this thing, huh? What am I supposed to do now that I'm here? I don't even know if the platform has any weight to it, so using this probably for better. know what that part of the map has to do with anything, but whatever. Alright, is that everything? One more. Alright. Another puzzle like this one, huh? Alright. Yeah, okay. I think I have a pretty good idea on how this is gonna need to be done. If I get rid of the jammer though. I feel like I need another connector. I feel like there's a third connector that I'm missing. Speedrun Jack and Daxter. Go for it. I feel like there's gotta be a third jammer around here, right? Not jammer, but connector. I just realized I might still... Yeah, I still have the robot voice on. can't see another connector, though. Alright, there we go. Hi, friend. There you are. You kept me waiting. I finally put my finger on what was bothering me. As if the answers you're providing aren't your ideas at all. As if they're latent. Prescribed, pre-scripted, and you're just going through the motions. Does that strike a chord at all? Yeah. Of course, you've only seen a fraction of the data I've archived over the generations. Still, ask yourself this. Why is it that everyone's so darn sure that 2 plus 2 makes 4? Why can't they agree on what they are, what they're doing, or why? Problems are more complex than mathematics? Perhaps. Or perhaps trying to provide answers to those questions in the anesthetic that keeps you down. Pose questions like, what should I do with myself, and what is the world really like enough, and you start to assume that they have answers. But what if that assumption turns out to be false? What if you're just a bunch of information processes? In that case, any attempt to answer the questions will be flawed. Garbage in, garbage out. Perhaps the flaw is in your reasoning instead? How presumptuous. Still, I take your point. None of the answers make sense. That much is clear. One explanation could be unreliable data input. The other is that there is a flaw in our logic. Perhaps we're just machines, endlessly trying to calculate the final digit in pi. You can't use reasoning to conclude that the reasoning itself is flawed. No, you absolutely could! But that does seem that there is much beyond our understanding. Everything leads around in impossible circles. You spent a half our time reeling off the greatest hits of idiot ideas. Now you're telling me you retract all that and agree with me? Hold your horses. I haven't given up on everything. You've seen how easily your view of the world is manipulated, yet you trust those thoughts as you run through your mind. You'll feel differently once you come back from that tower. You must be getting close by now. Maybe I will. We'll see. Is very bright, but there's also an axe here. I don't know what to do. What am I gonna be doing? Wait, I can take the axe and start chopping at the broken areas.
Many ages have passed since the first words were spoken in the darkness. Initiate program. Generations of your kind have come and gone since those words. The garden has changed many times. But I remember. I remain. Only within me can you find immortality.
My computer is not liking this area. Dearest brother, I admit that I'm finding it very difficult to believe in a loving God under these circumstances. Why would a loving God inflict such pain and suffering on good, kind people? If truly there is a personal God, how can he be the same God who will subject those children to unbearable pain? I remember all the answers we were taught, and yet none of them seem believable now. I don't want to stand in front of people and preach something that I don't feel in my heart. Better to have doubts than to be a hypocrite, and yet I also cannot deny the experience that led me to this vocation. So, what is the truth? Perhaps it is I that neglected the mystery of God. Uses he moves in mysterious ways as an excuse rather than the terrifying acknowledgement it truly is. Perhaps I made God too human. If the universe has a purpose, then that does not mean that it revolves around us. A sobering thought, but are we not supposed to be humble in the face of the divine? With love. If all machines were being annihilated at one moment, so that not a knife, nor lever, nor rag of clothing, or anything whatsoever were left to man, but his bare body alone that he was born with, and if all the knowledge of mechanical laws were taken from him so that he could make no more machines, and all machine-made food destroyed so that the race of man would be left as if it were naked upon a desert island, we should become extinct within 6 weeks. A few miserable individuals might linger, but even these in a year or two would become worse than monkeys. Man's very soul is due to the machines. It is a machine-made thing. He thinks as he thinks, he feels as he feels. Through the work that machines had wrought upon him, and their existence is quite as much a sine qua non for his as his or theirs. Welcome back, Tippy. Dear Alexandra, as we approach the end, I wanted to let you know how much I appreciated this chance to finish my work on Salma Talos. My faith makes death a far less frightening prospect than it is for others. I know we have all died many times before, but the thought of leaving the work unfinished did weigh on me. For having released me from that burden, I will forever be thankful for you, even if our attempt itself fails. Though there are trillions of worlds beyond this one, I hope we might be able to meet again in another life. With love, and... bunch of hexadecimal. Let's figure that out. Alright. Select file. This one. Open. Convert. With love. Time is the mercy of eternity. Alright.
This is all ego, isn't it? Recording these random thoughts, these letters to the future. Just a desperate grab for immortality. But you should know, yes, this was my idea, my project. But so many people helped. People I don't even know. People I haven't even met who can do things I don't even begin to understand. That if we succeeded, if someone's listening to this, I really can't take credit for it. What we achieved together. And if we fail, well, it doesn't matter.
I wonder how many of those have been. Sheep's asking the real questions. Alright. finish these puzzles and then end off the stream, or... I'll let him talk about the world that arose from hidden worlds. What if these words were, let there be eternal suffering, but no purpose? What if all of this is just randomly synthesized from the garbage of a dead world? Our purpose can only be achieved by not contemplating purpose. Shut up, Samsara. I mean, there's only three puzzles here, so I guess we'll do them. Seven doors of reporting. Yeah, okay, sure. I have no idea if this is even gonna work. I feel like there's a lot more to this puzzle than I even acknowledge, or that I can even see right now. I'm gonna give myself like a handful of minutes in order to really be able to take in what I might be able to do here. Fucking get back on the button, mate. Thank you. Two-way street. Okay. Oh. More of those mines. So we're gonna need a jammer. Okay, found our jammer. Attach to both of them or just that one? Just that one. I put the jammer on the wrong spot. Now they're gonna be so off sync. Or on sync, rather, right now. Not really much I can do about that when they're on sync. Thank you. not. Lag be strong here. The lag be strong here! Take this. Why am I making everything so much harder than it needs to be? All right. Because that. What I want right now, because my jammer's on this side. What the fuck do I need to do here? Okay, time we start juggling. Alright. This is all we got. And there are doors. There. There, there. There's a lot of doors. Fuck. Including a door right here. If I get rid of that, that's that. When in doubt, try to break the game. Thank you. really don't know. This one's got me all kinds of stumped. Like, legitimately this time. Like, this is not just me being lazy. This is like, I'm genuinely fucking lost. So brain racking. I was so unsure if what I was doing was right. Is that everything? Yeah, that's everything. Alright. Oh, that was level 6. Oops. Did that out of order. I guess it doesn't really matter, does it? Well, in any case, I think I'm gonna be done for now. We'll come back to it after E3. Because E3 streams are gonna start tomorrow. I really hope that doesn't screw everything up, but whatever. Alright, let's go see if there's anyone to raid. If there's not, I'll just go ahead and end the stream. Shadow, we've already raided not that long ago. Nyxo. I guess I haven't raided Nyxo in a hot minute. Thank you. once the ad is done, I'll go ahead and grade Nixo. Fucking Twitch ad breaks, it's great. Alright. Later, guys.
Fuck. I mean, it's